Our target is to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being throughout the life course. In order to combat diseases and invest in better health for everyone, we consider it crucial to deepen our understanding of these diseases. At the same time, we recognize the importance to develop prevention and treatment strategies tailored to the individual patient. To achieve our mission, novel transdisciplinary strategies are needed to fully cover the complexity of this problem. We are committed to build bridges between different research fields, such as oncology, cardiology, immunology, microbiology, psychiatry, epidemiology, virology, and public health.
We are a specialized medical center, an academic medical center, and that means we also specialize in the kinds of infections people get. We all get viruses, bacteria, parasites, that's part of life, but because of the way the world is changing and because of the way our patient population is changing, we see new problems, new infections being introduced, but also old infections, known infections with very different forms, appearances. So to be prepared for the future of infectious diseases in this specialized patient population, we do research that tries to predict what we can expect, but also then tries to understand how we can better prevent and treat these infections. So an example of how the work that we do in a global context puts departments together in joint research is the recent Zika epidemic. That was an infection that we've known for a long time, but that really started to spread very fast through mosquitoes when it entered the Americas. And what happened then is a new complication came to light in that when it infected pregnant women, they got children with very severe birth defects, with delayed brain development. So that has led to a lot of collaborative work between the travel clinic, the people specialized in neurological disease, bone development, neonatal development, virology, to try and understand how exactly does this virus work. Can we detect it? Can we find who is at risk of that complication? And ultimately, of course, can we treat and prevent it?
The most common cardiac arrhythmia is atrial fibrillation, and this is the cardiovascular epidemic of the 21st century. And the problem is that we cannot effectively treat this arrhythmia because we do not know the underlying mechanism. We are trying to unravel this mechanism by measuring electrical signals directly from the surface of the heart. And for this we use a special device which is designed by the Technical University of Delft. And with this tool we visualize the electrical activation through the heart muscle so that we can identify areas which are abnormally activated. And by using this tool, we've already discovered a new mechanism of this arrhythmia. So in the future, we have to focus more on prevention instead of therapy of diseases. And with the technological development, we have developed watches, necklaces, bracelets, smart tattoos, and they all monitor health parameters. We can do that now at a large scale. So we have a huge amount of information which enables us to identify targets for not only therapy of diseases, but also for prevention of diseases. So the advantage of these tools is that it also stimulates the management of patients on their health.
To reduce the number of diseased persons and the number of premature mortalities caused by non-communicable diseases and infectious diseases, multiple factors need to be considered simultaneously, as each of these factors have their own specific role, and yet also influence response to other factors. This system approach, generating holistic knowledge, will ultimately lead to efficient prevention of non-communicable diseases and infectious diseases, and the development of innovative interventions for patients and society. This will promote human well-being and health, leading to improved health for all.